हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। माई सेल्फ योजना कुंभावत, लेक्चरर इन केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग ऑफ के वाग पॉलिटेक्निक नासिक। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस बायोमेडिकल वेस्ट, दिस टॉपिक विद यू विच कम्स अंडर द सब्जेक्ट एनवायरमेंटल टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ थर्ड ईयर डिप्लोमा इन केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस डिफरेंट सोर्सेज ऑफ बायोमेडिकल वेस्ट, then classification of biomedical waste, also segregation, storage and transportation of biomedical waste, and at the end of this video I am going to discuss about the different treatment methods used for the treatment of or disposal of this biomedical waste. This biomedical waste is also called as hospital waste. It is a kind of waste which contains infectious material that usually appears to be of medical. This biomedical waste include bandages, syringes, gloves, drugs and blood contacted supplies, etc. This biomedical waste may be defined as solid, liquid or the fluid waste, including its container and any intermediate product which is generated during the diagnosis, treatment or human immunization of human beings or the animals. This biomedical waste differs from the other type of waste like hazardous waste such as chemical and radioactive material. Different sources of biomedical waste are the waste which is coming out from the slaughterhouses or from the hospitals or clinic, or the waste which is coming out from the research laboratories, or the waste which is coming out from the funeral homes, or the waste which is coming out from the physician, from the dentist and from the veterinarians, and the culture, that is microbiological cultures or stocks, also comes under this biomedical waste. Biomedical waste is classified into generally 8 categories. First one is a radioactive material. This radioactive waste can be radiopharmaceuticals and from the nuclear medicine procedures or from the radioimmunology treatment methods. Second is pharmaceutical waste. The waste which is coming out from the pharmaceutical industries, it may be a raw material waste or it may be the different processed waste. Also, medicines and tablets which are expired comes under this pharmaceutical waste area. Next is chemical waste. Chemical waste shows ignability, corrosivity, reactivity or the product that produce the toxic leachate. Next is gas containers. The gas containers which are used for patients and which came in contact with the patients comes under this category. Next is toxic substances. Toxic material which is generally used in hospitals or clinics comes under this category, and these toxic substances hazardous to the human being. Next is sharp material. This sharp material contains needles, syringes, scalpel blades, blood specimen, pasture and the broken glass exposed to the infectious agent. Human organs. After operation in hospital, human body parts or human body fluid or human tissues are removed, and when the postmortem takes place, that time also this body parts are removed. So this kind of waste comes under this category. And last one is infectious waste. This infectious waste is nothing but the contaminated waste with the blood, excretion of patient or the secretion from the infectious diseases, etc. Also the animal waste comes under the classification of biomedical waste. This animal waste may be a decayed animal carcasses or the body parts of body fluids or the which comes out during the research activity. So this is nothing but the classification of biomedical waste. This biomedical waste is first segregated, means the separation of this biomedical waste takes place initially. After segregation, the storage of that waste takes place in different containers, and after storage, this biomedical waste is transported to the dumping area or to the treatment area. Segregation of waste is the most important aspect in the process of waste management. It allows special attention to be given to relatively small quantities of waste and thereby reducing the risk as well as cost of handling and disposal. This waste is generally classified into the two categories. One is general or non-hazardous or non-infectious material, and the second category is infectious or hazardous medical waste. We will discuss first category, which is general or non-hazardous and non-infectious waste. The waste like paper, fabric, glass, food, residues, containers which are not contaminated with any blood or any body fluids or other infectious agents comes under this, and they do not require any special treatment. We can easily dispose this this kind of waste in the general solid waste treatment methods. Next is infectious or hazardous medical waste. Proper segregation of this waste is necessary for efficient and economic treatment and disposal. This kind of waste is mainly transmit the infection and waste which are having the properties of toxicity and low level of radioactivity. It includes body parts and body fluids removed during any surgery. Second part is storage of waste. Segregated waste of different categories need to be collected in the identifiable container. Sharp needs special attention as they contain pathogen, and they should be damaged before putting into the container, and they should always be disposed in a puncture proof container to avoid direct contact with the sharps. Then plastic bags for storing the waste must be placed inside a sturdy container. A lid should be provided to cover the opening of the bag to avoid the direct contact with the atmosphere. Every room of hospital should have the containers for the various types of waste so that waste can be easily segregated. Each container should be labeled clearly to show the ward or room where it was kept so that it becomes easy for its further treatment, or for identification it become easier, and for storage of different types of waste, the color coding and types of container have been proposed by Ministry of Environment and Forest. Different type of waste is segregated in different color bins. In this figure you can see color coding of containers for segregation of biomedical waste. This black color container shows, or the black color container is used for non-infected waste or cytotoxic drug and chemical waste. Red color containers are used for the solid waste in like infected resin, pop cast, etc. Yellow color bins are used for the anatomical waste like placenta, pathology waste and body parts. Blue color bins are used for infected plastic, syringes, gloves and plastic waste, etc. And the white color beans are used for the sharps, needles and cut glasses, etc. The waste which is stored in these black color beans is sent to the secure landfilling process. From the red plastic container, waste is sent for deep burial, and the waste which is stored in yellow plastic container is sent for the deep burial, and the waste which is stored in this blue color container is sent for recycling, and the sharps and needles are sent to the sharp pit section. And the third category is transportation, means after segregation, this transportation of solid waste is necessary. From the source area, means from the hospital, we send this to the disposal area or the treatment area for the transfer of this solid waste or biomedical waste. From the source to the disposal area, transportation is needed. And for transportation, there should be a special vehicle is provided to prevent access to and direct contact with the waste by the transportation operators. They should be properly closed, and they should be leak proof, and they should never be transported with general municipal waste, and this should be kept separate. And the driver should be trained in the procedure he must follow in case of accidental spillage. Here we can see the vehicle which is used for the transportation of biomedical waste, and this symbol shows the biohazard. Next is, after transportation to the disposal area, treatment of biomedical waste takes place, and it is necessary to treat this biomedical waste because improper management can cause direct impact on the health of community and to the environment. So there are five broad categories of biomedical waste treatment technology. One is mechanical waste, second is thermal process. Thermal process is again classified into the autoclaving, microwave treatment, incineration and plasma system. Next process for the biomedical waste treatment is chemical process, irradiation process and the biological process. Mechanical process is generally used for the shredding of biomedical waste. In this process, compaction and shredding of biomedical waste takes place. Compaction is nothing but to reduce the volume of biomedical waste, and shredding is used for the granulation or grinding or pulping of the biomedical waste. This mechanical process is facilitated waste handling or to process the waste in conjunction with the other processes. Mechanical processes are not considered as acceptable medical waste treatment system, and the disadvantages of this mechanical process are aerospoiling or the spilling of microorganism into the environment, and which may create the unhygienic condition. Next process of biomedical waste treatment is thermal process. Principle of this thermal process is to heat the waste to decontaminate or destroy medical waste. Means in this process, at high temperature, we destroy all the biomedical waste. Generally, 49 to 91 degrees Celsius, this much temperature is sufficient to dead the microorganism, and 100 degrees Celsius or above the 100 degrees Celsius is useful for the dead of living microorganisms. Thermal process takes place in two ways. One is low heat system and the second one is high heat system. Generally, low heat system consist of steam, hot water or electromagnetic radiation, and in high heat system generally combustion, pyrolysis and plasma treatment takes place, and the temperature of this high heat system is in between the 600 to 5500 degree Celsius. We will see one by one different thermal treatments. First treatment is autoclaving. In autoclaving, it is a low thermal heat process, and in autoclaving we generally use steam, and in this system this steam comes in direct contact with the waste in a controlled manner and for sufficient duration to disinfect the waste. In this figure you can see, in this system, this chemical which need to be sterilized or which need to be given a thermal treatment, it comes in contact with this steam. Okay, this red line shows the steam which is entering from this pipe to this tank. And here we can see this steam comes in directly contact with this sterilizing material. Okay, and after the process and after the sterilization process, the air is then sent to the further treatment process. This autoclaving can takes place by three ways. One is gravity type autoclaving, which takes place at the temperature of 121 degree Celsius and for operating time of 60 to 90 minutes. Second one is pre-vacuum autoclave. The temperature for this pre-vacuum autoclave is 132 degree Celsius and the operating time of this system is 30 to 60 minutes. And the third one is retort system autoclave. Temperature of this retort autoclave is above the 150 degree Celsius and operating time is less than the other system required for this autoclave. Next process is microwave treatment. Unlike other treatment in which heat waste externally is used, but in microwave heating occurs inside the waste material. This process involves pre-shedding of material, injecting it with steam and heating it for 25 minutes at 95 degrees Celsius. And in this process, electromagnetic radiation spectrum lying between the frequencies of 300 to 3 lakhs megahertz are used, and this results in the microbial deactivation. In figure we can see this microwave. In this sample is given for the microwave treatment, and in this figure we can see, in this graph we can see this lower line shows the conventional heating and the upper line shows the microwave heating. In conventional heating we can see this red color is given at the outside of this circle, and in microwave heating red color is given at the inside of this circle. At this line we can see blue color shows for lower temperature, and at the highest temperature it shows the red color. Means what? In conventional system, outer system is heated most, but in microwave system inner system is heated most. Okay, that's why this microwave system is very useful, because in microwave system inner part of the waste is broken out or it is burned easily compared to the conventional heating system. Next method used in the thermal treatment is incineration. Principle of this incineration is high temperature combustion under controlled conditions to convert waste containing infections and pathological material to inert mineral residues and gases. Means in incineration, we convert this biomedical waste into directly ashes. This incineration takes place by two ways. One is by rotary kiln incinerator and second is multiple hearth incineration. In rotary kiln incinerator, we can see this one is a rotary cylinder which rotates continuously. In this system, we provided biomedical waste and this system is heated externally and this biomedical waste is then converted into the ash and which is removed from here and the air which is collected over here and which contains some ashes and some carbon particles in that is then sent to the air cleaning system and from this it is sent to the atmosphere. In this rotary kiln incinerator, secondary combustion chamber is also used. Means in first chamber, 800 to 1200 degrees Celsius heating takes place. And after this, it is sent to the another secondary combustion chamber where the 1000 to 2500 degrees Celsius heating takes place. Means here we can see the temperature of the system is very high. That is, it is up to 2500 degrees Celsius. So at this temperature, the biomedical waste is completely converts into the ash. So this treatment process is very effective. And the next one is multiple hearth incinerator. This is also the burning of biomedical waste process. In this process, we can see the earth system is given. We can see this is a central shaft. The out hearth are attached to this central shaft and the in hearth are attached to the wall of this incinerator. Solid waste comes from the upper side and it passes through this earth and it comes downward and the air is provided from the bottom of this incineration tank. When this hot air which is coming from this inner pipe to this tank, this air when comes in contact with this biomedical waste, that hot air which is at 1000 to 2000 degrees Celsius burns the biomedical waste which is coming from upper side and that waste is then converted into the ash and that ash is removed from the bottom sides and the air the air contains the carbon particles which are formed after combustion and this air is then sent to the further air filtration process. Means where this carbon molecules which are mixed into the air is separated into the air filtration system. Okay, so this rotary kiln incinerator and the multiple hearth incinerator, these both the system are used for the conversion of biomedical waste to the ash. Means we are decreasing the volume of this biomedical waste and we are directly converting into the ash which is non-hazardous compared to biomedical waste. The countries or the areas where the dumping areas are not available, there incineration process takes place. Next heating process or next thermal process is plasma system. This operate at a temperature of 10,000 degrees Celsius. In plasma system, plasma torch or burner for heating the waste to super high temperature is used. They operate at oxygen deficient mode and off gases need to be composted separately. And the residue of this plasma system is glass-like substances. Next process is chemical process. In this process, first biomedical waste need to be shredded for the efficient contact with the chemicals. Principle of this chemical process is disinfection of waste is done with the use of chemical. The chemicals which are used in this method is chlorine compounds, phenolic compounds, iodine, alcohol, formaldehyde, alcohol and combinations, etc. In this system, water is needed to bring the chemicals and microorganisms together as necessary to achieve inactivation. Next method of biomedical waste treatment is irradiation process. Principle of this process is exposing of waste to the ultraviolet or ionizing radiation in an enclosed container. Irradiation process uses cobalt 40 and electron beam accelerator unit for irradiation and sterilizing the medical waste. It requires post-shedding to render the waste recognizable. And the last system of biomedical waste treatment is biological process. In biological process, biological enzymes are used for treating with the medical waste. It is claimed that biological reaction will not only decontaminate the waste but also causes the destruction of all organic constituents present in the biomedical waste, so that only plastic, glass and other inerts will remain in the residue, and we segregate this plastic, glass and other residue from this biological process and then we send it to the further treatment. I hope you like my video. Thank you for watching my video. We will meet soon with my new video. Thank you everyone.